Good wives, said a hard-featured dame of 50, I'll tell ye a piece of my mind. It would be greatly for the public behoof if we women, being of mature age, and church members in good repute, should have the handling of such malefactresses as this Hester Prynne. What think ye, gossips, if the hussy stood up for judgment before us five that are now here in a knot together, would she come off with such a sentence as the worshipful magistrates have awarded? Mary, I trow not.
Excuse me, Mrs. McKee, that was the bail.
Oh, of course. Well, have a lovely day. And think about Dimmesdale and our poor Hester.
Does anyone know what's going on in here?
No. I tried to read the book, but it's about Puritans from a million years ago.
We should bag this class tomorrow. It's not like we're going to miss anything. Or be missed.
It's a plan.
We're not going to Mrs. McKee's class, are we? Please say no.
We've got the big game tomorrow, and I, for one, could use a break.
It's not like Mrs. McKee will ever miss us.
Okay, let's go. Nothing to it.
Oh, girls, good. You're all right. I missed you in class today.
Hi. Two lemonades, a large popcorn, and a candy bar.
So what's the A for?
Oh, absentee.
What?
I cut class, got busted, now they're making me work here and wear this.
Lame.
Yeah, no kidding.
No, not the punishment. You guys, I mean, we're dying in there without you. I can't believe you do something so stupid and selfish when so many people are counting on you.
535, please.
Short-term thinking.
Why don't they just stone us? Yeah, no kidding. Now I know what Hester Prynne must have felt like.